Tokyo's kind of the capital of Zoo TV, I think. Well, what again, do you think, The Edge?
I was just going to say, it's not about the hardware, it's about the software behind the hardware. Software like this and
menswear,
brains and, you know.
But that software and that hardware cuts across borders. You know, you've had Salman Rushdie on stage. You've broadcasted to Sarajevo.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And
got into trouble for it.
Yeah, but you circumvent traditional filtering of information by doing this. You do create, in a strange kind of sense, your own little Europa, your own little continent of information.
Well, that's very well put. And we had this spotlight of media attention on us we wanted to use it, that's all.
Yeah.
And, you know, we broadcast bullshit and sometimes we don't. You know, and it comes and goes, and you come to a Zoo TV show, you don't know what you're going to get exactly. And we have this technology, we might as well use it, you know. They asked us to do it. It was this people in the Sarajevo that wanted us to do it, and they sent people to see us when we were in Italy, which is like 200 miles away, to say, you know, come and play there. And they told us you can't come because it's getting too heavy. And we said, is there anything else we could do? And we came up with this satellite link. So, you know, what we're going to say, no, f*** off. Some people won't like it. Some people will be offended by it. Baby, baby.
You end on love. Gone through all the high-tech toys, you end on love. Love, love, love.
We're suckers. That's the truth.
Well, maybe love is all there is, you know? Yeah. Live and death, yeah. And love in between.
Rock and roll should be everything, you know. It should be anything. It should be able to be, you know, whatever you want it to be in that mood. You know, serious, not so serious, soulful, bullshit, sexual, spiritual.
Well, is that why you did an instant album with Europa?
Wouldn't call it instant, but a quick album. Well, at the end of the Acting Baby album, I said as a joke to the others, because we ended up doing most of the work in the last 3 weeks, and this has happened to us before, so I said, well, maybe the next time we go into the studio, we should just choose a release date, and then decide how long we want to spend in the studio, and just go in. And actually, that is almost what happened with the record, because the deadline was the start of the tour. And we stole a few days, you know, we actually started flying back home after shows in Europe to finish the album. That went on for about a week and a half, but still, there's nothing that sharpens the mind more than a very serious deadline. And in a way, you know, it helps you, it limits you, and limitations and lack of options sometimes is all you need to get the work done.
Frank Blade Runner.
You did that high tech as well, did you not? So did your vocal part down the high tech highway?
Yeah, well, you know, I'd have been, you know, I'm very glad I didn't do it in the room with him, you know.
Where's that?
Well, you know, what would you do? It's duck, get out of his way, I mean.
I have said to myself, this affair never gonna go so well.
But why should I try to resist when baby I know so well? Look, I'm just, you know, it's great. We're at the top of the world and people ask us to do these things and I'm happy. Frank Sinatra wants me to sing on an album, I just say yes.
We have possibly the most famous quote out of all the stuff we've ever done with you, and it's the very first interview with City TV and Much Music did, and the quote was,
"Don't you ever worry that all that success might spoil you?"
I hope it does.
Has it spoiled yet?
Spoiled us, it'll be rotten. And
nicely though?
Yeah, nicely. Look, it's the work that's important, and you know, in the end, the rest is really unimportant. And we have an amazing audience; they're very elastic, and we have stretched and them and pushed them, and they followed us out on a ledge. And I think we've been very lucky. I think, you know, not many bands would get away with this, and we're in this position that you know, people play what we write on the radio and come to see us play. So we're in this position. I think it's our duty to abuse it.
Rock and roll the disrespect it deserves.
Exactly.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen!